term greenhouse, we mean the building of a residence or a construction in a way that is ecologically conscientious and friendly to the environment and its inhabitants. Initially, this is accomplished with bioclimatic architectural planning, which is based on traditional architecture and takes into consideration the particulars of the local environment. With a rational approach to the various climatic parameters, it introduces new values of modern architecture, which seek to restore the relationship between humans and nature. The use of eco-friendly materials is of equal importance, as well as taking advantage of renewable sources of energy. In our country, many new homeowners have opted to take advantage of government incentives, in addition to the many benefits, both in terms of health and quality of life, gained when building greenhouses. However, a big majority, thoughtlessly, continue to burden the environment with houses which consume enormous quantities of energy and are built with materials that are not friendly towards the environment or people. As a result, Cyprus is becoming more and more dependent on oil, with all the environmental consequences involved. We can learn a lot from our ancestors. Even though their houses were built in simple ways, they were certainly more functional and friendlier toward the environment. They used materials that were natural insulators, correct orientation, and internal open spaces. The openings on the southern sides were relatively bigger compared to those of the rest of the house, in order to maximize the sun's warmth in the winter and minimize it during the summer months. Furthermore, courtyards provided additional cooling. It is not surprising that we find a worldwide tendency to return to this way of designing houses. The main values of bioclimatic architectural planning are realized in the winter and summer periods. During the winter period, the main objective is to take full advantage of the sun's energy, which is achieved by placing large windows on the southern side, while at the same time ensuring minimal heat loss by placing less frequently used spaces on the northern side. For the summer period, shaded areas on the southern side serve to minimize overheating. Together with openings that enhance airflow, which means the flow of air through the building, a pleasant and cool space is maintained throughout the summer. Thermal insulation constitutes one of the basic parameters of modern architectural planning and is best at conserving heat. The thermal insulation of a building refers to its protection against the weather conditions and is ensured by insulating walls and windows using both artificial and natural materials. The insulation of the roof, which can consist of materials that are natural insulators and plant growth, is also very important. Along with the use of double glazing windows to prevent heat loss in the winter or summer, a well-insulated home can save up to 60% of its energy. It should be stressed that the passive measures refer to elements which are incorporated from the beginning in the architectural design of a building. Is an inexhaustible source of energy. With the use of photovoltaic panels, we can take advantage of this energy, supplying the needs of the house with no burden to the environment. The electricity generated through the photovoltaic panels is used to cover the energy needs of the house. In many cases, the electricity produced exceeds these needs, and any excess electricity can be sold back to the Electricity Authority of Cyprus. The installation is simple. All that is needed is a cable connecting the Electricity Authority's main panel to the photovoltaic panel. At a certain depth, the ground's temperature is constant throughout the year. Water pipes run through the ground, absorbing the temperature, transferring it back to the house. Consequently, the house has a constant temperature throughout the winter and summer. Water is the water gathered from the drains of kitchen sinks, bathroom sinks and bathtubs, which is collected at a central filter system. This is then treated, cleaned and reused for other needs of the house. Making changes in the surroundings of a house can improve the microclimatic conditions. Therefore, plants can help make for a better interior climate. For the garden, it is important to select plants that need little water, that do not require pesticides, and that can tolerate the drought climatic conditions of Cyprus. When buying domestic appliances, we have the responsibility of asking the supplier for the product's energy label, which according to legal guidelines should be found on the product. This way, you are informed of the energy efficiency of the appliance. Houses that are equipped with such appliances can conserve up to 30% of their energy.
Τα κίνητρα τα οποία δίδουμε και τα δίδουμε εδώ και 5 χρόνια με μεγάλη επιτυχία, διότι τα έχουν αγκαλιάσει μεγάλος αριθμός ανθρώπων, μιλούμε για αρκετές χιλιάδες, έχουμε ξεπεράσει τις 45.000 αιτήσεων μέχρι σήμερα, μπορούν να παραδειγμηθούν σε αυτούς που παρεμβαίνουν στο κέλυφος του κτηρίου, προπάντων στις ταράτσες και στις οροφές, γενικά και θερμομονώνουν, αυτούς που παρεμβαίνουν και βάζουν διπλά παράθυρα και με σωστές παρεμβάσεις στις πόρτες ή αλλού, και δίδομαι ουσιαστικά εκεί κίνητρα τα οποία βοηθούν και μειώνουν την κατανάλωση. Έχουμε επιμετρήσεις σε αυτόν τον τομέα, όπου έχουμε βελτίωση της θερμοκρασίας στους θερινούς μήνες, που χρειάζεται ουσιαστικός ρωσισμός κατά 6 βαθμούς Κελσίου, αλλά και για θέρμανση το χειμώνα, με μείωση της κατανάλωσης πετρελαίου.
Occasionally there are concerns that an eco-friendly house is not beautiful or appealing. These concerns, however, emanate from wrong information. An ecological house does not differ in any way from other houses. It can have any architectural, structural, and aesthetic value we want.
Η ανέγερση ενός τέτοιου σπιτιού ομολογώ ότι δεν ήταν καθόλου δύσκολη, τουλάχιστον όχι τόσο όσο πιθανόν κανείς να ανέμενε. Στην Κύπρο τα υλικά υπάρχουν, η τεχνογνωσία υπάρχει, φτάνει κανείς να ψάξει και να δει πέραν των συνηθισμένων πηγών που έχουμε όλοι μάθει. Εξωτερικά το κέλυφος είναι πλήρως θερμομονωμένο και τα τζάμια τα οποία λαμβάνουν αρκετή επιφάνεια του σπιτιού είναι υψηλής ενεργειακής απόδοσης. Για παράδειγμα, τον χειμώνα περνώντας ο ήλιος ζεσταίνει το σκληρό πάτωμα που έχουμε επιλέξει, οπότε διατηρεί τη θερμοκρασία του. Ενώ το καλοκαίρι με κάποιες επιπλέον κινήσεις, όπως για παράδειγμα η ευθυγράμμιση συγκεκριμένων παραθύρων του σπιτιού, να υποβοηθεί την κατανομή του αέρα και να κλιματίζεται χωρίς καν την ανάγκη κλιματιστικών ή επιπρόσθετων μέσων. Μέσα στα παθητικά, όπως αποκαλούνται μέτρα βιοκλιματισμού, όπως είναι για παράδειγμα το θερμομονωμένο κέλυφος ή τα τζάμια ψηλής ενεργειακής απόδοσης, είναι ας πούμε και η μόνωση της οροφής. Ένα πράγμα το οποίο θεωρούμε τουλάχιστον ότι είναι πάρα πολύ σημαντικό. Στην Κύπρο η ειδική και η τεχνογνωσία υπάρχουν. Θεωρώ ότι μέσα σε τούτα τα πλαίσια δεν υπάρχει καν ανάγκη να συμβιβαστεί κανείς ούτε σε σχεδιασμό, ούτε σε εσωτερική ή εξωτερική διακόσμηση, διότι παρέχονται πλέον απεριόριστες δυνατότητες. Φτάνει να πω ότι μέσα στους πιο ζεστούς καλοκαιρινούς μήνες, ήδη Ιούλιο και Αύγουστο, ο λογαριασμός ήταν κατά 60% χαμηλότερος από το διαμέρισμα στο οποίο έμενα προηγούμενα. Όταν ακούει κανείς, όπως και εγώ προηγούμενα, έννοιες όπως βιοκλιματισμός, ενεργειακή απόδοση, εξοικονόμηση ενέργειας, θεωρούμε ότι είναι κάτι δαπανηρό, ακαλέσθητο ή δύσκολο. Ομολόγω ότι με την εμπειρία που απέκτησα κατά την ανέγερση της οικίας, ουδέν αναλυθέστερο.
The building of a house and acquisition of a home constitutes not only a dream, but also an important moment in the life of a family or person anywhere in the world. The energy sources we use are limited, and we need to realize that with thoughtless consumption, we are depriving future generations of them. We have to change our philosophy and realize that our actions and their catastrophic consequences render the restoration of our environment almost unattainable. Taking into consideration this inconvenient truth, we have the moral obligation to inform ourselves and to entrust the experts with the construction of greenhouses and their multifaceted advantages on the quality of life of each individual, but also for the environment of our country and the entire planet.